reported at the Iranian parliament, a shooting and hostage-taking situation that has been reported there. A gunman, having shot down the security guard, already stormed inside the parliament building. Agencies further reporting that a person who entered the Iranian parliament today started shooting at the guards. He shot one of the guards in the leg and then ran away. Remember, sketchy details coming in on a report on updates on the news which is still developing. The Iranian parliament attack, wherein which the guard has been killed after three attackers. We're getting in reports that there is a possibility of three attackers there inside parliament, one of them having already killed a guard at parliament. And another attack is underway as well, which is at the shrine of Ayatollah Khomeini. Unconfirmed reports on that, but could these really be twin attacks in Iran? Two simultaneous attacks taking place on two pivotal locations, one inside the parliament building and one at the shrine of Ayatollah Khomeini, which of course is a strong message that would be sent out here for the manner in which Ayatollah Khomeini's shrine has been attacked here in Iran as well.
On Wednesday morning, three armed gunmen stormed into Iranian parliament and opened fire, killing one security guard and injuring a few. However, it's not clear yet if the attack was a suicide attack or not. Within a couple of minutes, another blast took place at the mausoleum of Imam Khomeini in Tehran. The attacker has blown himself inside the mausoleum.
And in order to update you on that, breaking news from Iran, where state media say that a gunman have opened fire inside the Iranian parliament in the capital, Tehran. Now, according to one local news agency, it's reporting that a security guard was killed and several other people wounded in the incident at the parliamentary complex. Officials are said to have arrested one gunman. Now, there are also separate reports in Iranian media that there'd been another shooting in a southern part of the capital. That was at the mausoleum housing the tomb of the founder of the Islamic Republic, Ayatollah Khomeini. Several people are reported to have been shot. Details still coming in, more on both those incidents as we have it.
First, with this developing story out of Iran, and the semi-official Fars news agency is reporting a number of people have been wounded in an attack on the mausoleum of Ayatollah Khomeini in southern Tehran. There have also been reports of a shooting incident in Iran's parliament. France 24's Doug Herbert is following this for us. Doug, the details here are still very sketchy. What more have you been hearing?
Yeah, varying reports coming in, all coming in from Iran's semi-official news agencies, including the one you quoted, Fars. Like you said, multiple, a series of two separate attacks in two separate locations in the capital, Tehran, one in the parliament building itself in central Tehran, and then another about 20 kilometers, 12 miles to the south at a very, very symbolic site, the shrine to the Ayatollah Ruhollah Khomeini, who was really the founder of the Iranian Islamic Republic in 1979, and he was also its first supreme leader. So you don't get too much more symbolic than that. In the case of the shrine, you have one report saying that there was a suicide bomber blew him or herself up at a bank just outside of the mausoleum, and that some other attackers were arrested at the site. In the case of the parliament, you also have conflicting information in some cases, but what we can say is there were initial reports said perhaps it was one attacker, but subsequently it seems that there was there were several gunmen who stormed into the parliament building. According to one lawmaker, some of them were armed with assault rifles, with AK-47 rifles. Reports of several people wounded within the parliament. There had even been some reports, unconfirmed by us, of a security guard, possibly a security guard who had been killed. Like I said, that has not been confirmed, but what we can say for sure is that these attacks happened at the same time, about 12 miles apart, at both very, very symbolic sites for different reasons, the parliament being highly fortified, surrounded by multiple security checkpoints, the shrine to the Islamic Republic's founder, which is why the reports out of Iran and its news agency suggest that these attacks were coordinated in some way, shape, or form.
Doug, we don't often see attacks like this in Iran.
You're absolutely right. I mean, last year you did have Iran saying that it had foiled what it said, by its own words, was one of the biggest plots by terror groups against Tehran, the capital, and other major cities. What we do know is that Iran has a majority Shiite population. The Shiites are considered apostates to the faith by the Islamic State group. And as we also know, that Iran has been providing key ground forces in a couple of countries, notably Syria and Iraq, in fighting the Islamic State group and Sunni jihadists. So while the motivation of the assailants in this attack are still unclear, are still unknown, there is that clear clear division within the Muslim world between Shiite-dominated Iran and a lot of the Sunni jihadists out there who see everything Iran does and says as being absolutely heretical and apostates to the faith.
All right, Doug, thanks for that. And as Doug said, this is an ongoing situation. We're just hearing now from the Tasnim news agency, quoting sources on the ground, that at least seven people have died in that attack at the Iranian parliament, with another four reportedly being taken hostage. This is a developing situation. We'll bring you the latest on it as we get it here on France 24.
In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, the Islamic State has declared war on the heretics and apostates of the Islamic Republic of Iran. And all sarcasm aside, the significance of this attack cannot be overstated. ISIS and Iran are already technically at odds in Syria through Iran's proxy puppet army Hezbollah, and also in Iraq with the Shiite militias. But this is a direct attack at the heart of the Islamic Republic of Iran, in their parliament, by multiple gunmen penetrating one of the most heavily defended areas in the country, and killing multiple people and taking hostages. As if to punctuate this message, they've also launched what early reports describe as a suicide bombing attack inside the mausoleum of the founder of the Islamic Republic of Iran, the revered Shiite figure of Ayatollah Khomeini. I mean, Ayatollah Khomeini, after Imam Ali and Muhammad, I mean, that's basically one of the top figures in all of Shiite Islam. Such an attack on Iran will cause the hardline of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard, they're going to howl for the blood of the Islamic State and the escalation of the war under caliphate in Syria and Iraq. Could that mean the introduction of hordes of official Iranian Revolutionary Guard forces inside Syria and Iraq instead of their proxy Shiite militia groups and Hezbollah? If so, this terribly complicates the already confusing war against ISIS, as the United States would essentially be hostile to both ISIS and Iranian forces. Would a massive introduction of Iranian forces further into the Arab heartland prompt a reaction from the new Arab Gulf State Alliance to counter Iran? Certainly the last thing Saudi Arabia and Egypt want is Iranian forces expanding their role and footprint in traditionally Arab lands. Throw in the Kurds, Turkish armed forces, Hezbollah, Bashar Assad's Syrian army, various factions of moderate rebels and other Islamist factions like the Al-Qaeda-aligned Al-Nusra Front, this is beginning to look like the Lebanese Civil War of the 1970s and 1980s. Just a big, complicated mess. If ISIS and Iran want to fight, one thing is clear. No matter who wins, we lose. I'm the Neo-Unrealist. Stay tuned, because we're definitely going to be hearing more about this as more details emerge.
This story's all here. This whole thing was a trap.
They're not hunting us. We're in the middle of a war.
They're using us as bait.
You're ugly! Son of a...